Well, welcome back, guys, to Banjo-Tooie. Let's continue on. Alright, so last time we had just finished up everything that we could currently do at Witchy World, so it's time to move on to the next world. Now, we had just opened this area up last time by splitting the two characters up. Now it's time to learn a new ability. Excuse me. Ice eggs. Freezing cold, but that's the price for launching eggs of solid ice. So we now have access to ice eggs. Thank you kindly, Jam Jars. Right, next thing we're gonna do is climb along this ledge. Because over here is a train switch. So now if we wanted to, we could bring Chuffy the train over here. There's not much point though at the moment though. Oh well, at least we would have eventually had to open that switch anyway, so we might as well do it. Out of my way. So let's continue on. There's Mumbo's skull. We won't enter it just yet. Oh. Out of my way. So we activated another one of Jam Jar's warp silos there. Now there is a little path here. What this switch will do it forms a bridge for us. Now that leads to a world called Hailfire Peaks, but we don't have access to it yet. We'll just go check it out real quick though. Raw to you too. So yeah, this is Hailfire Peaks, which I think is a kind of old world. No pun intended. And up here is a Globo. Now I'm gonna go ahead and give that Globo over to Mumbo now, just so I don't forget about it later. Oh! Oh, silly me! That got me killed. That wasn't supposed to happen. Oh well. At least it's not like in Banjo-Kazooie where you had lives. You have infinite lives in this game. Okay, back to where we were. Hey, Mumbo. Now, what Mumbo will do here at this location is he actually acts as like a healer, so he'll heal someone that's sick. But unfortunately, he doesn't have a patient at the moment, so there's really nothing he can do right now. But at least he has a Globo, so we can just straight up control him later. Oh. Alrighty then, so it's time to start the fourth world of the game. Jolly Roger's Lagoon. Tooie Lagoon. Come visit the charming resort of Jolly Roger's Lagoon. Hire a wave racer from Blubber's, shop at Pano's, or drop in at Jolly's for a refreshing ginger beer. Fun for all the family! Let's go! So yes, welcome to Jolly Roger's Lagoon. I do like the music for this world. Now notice how this ground here looks a little strange. Well, if we drill into it, we found a doubloon. This is a doubloon. They are the only currency accepted in Jolly Roger's Lagoon. Avast me hearties, we be digging for gold. So yeah, if we dig each of these up, we'll find some more doubloons. Oh, actually, that one has a jump pad in it. But we can't use it just yet, because Banjo's too heavy with Kazooie combined. Now notice how that monument there in the center of town has a crack in it? Well, what do you do with a crack? You blow it up! And it revealed a split-up pad. Or, split-up pads, I should say. Okay, the shock jump pad. We'll use that in a moment. Arr, more gold. Alright, I think I'll stop with the pirate voice now. So let's just go ahead and collect all of these doubloons here, since they're just waiting for us to take. You would think that someone else would have spotted these coins by now. Over here, you'll notice that there's a couple of pigs. This one appears to have a third arm deformity. Help us sort our pool out, Mr. Bear. What's wrong? Looks fine to me. Kazooie. We want to go swimming, but the water is polluted and icy cold. This one may take some time. Now, Banjo is right about that. Pickles pushed me in the other week, and look what's happened to my arm. Well, I didn't want to say anything. Thanks, I'm a little touchy about it, as you might expect. Kazooie, that's not nice. A third leg? Weird. Alright, we'll try to sort out your pool. Why can't you just go swimming over here? Wouldn't that make more sense? Ah, video game logic. Anyway, let's go ahead and use this shock jump pad. Okay, that got us to the roof of Jolly's Tavern. Oh my goodness, the slowdown. Hey, don't you bite at me. Get out of here. So we'll just climb along this ledge here. That one tried to blend in by being green-colored. Alright, so straight away we found the first extra honeycomb piece of this world. Now we'll jump over here. Skull Beach Skull. What? Ah. So this is an access pipe that leads to the basement of the waste disposal plant in Grunty Industries. This is a switch. Let's turn off the toxic waste disposal. Help! I'm pretty sure that's a Minjo in this area, so he'll try to attack us if we get too close. Well, that takes care of the pollution, but there's still the temperature problem. Thanks, giant teddy bear. Now our water is crystal clear. Now, unfortunately, we won't be able to solve the temperature problem for quite some time, because we need to go all the way to one of the last worlds of the game called Cloud Cuckoo Land. So that's not a problem we'll be able to solve anytime soon. Aha! I knew you were a Minjo. Alright, I think that's it for here, so let's get back to Jolly Roger's Lagoon. Oops, wrong way. At least now we can swim around in it. And more doubloons, yay! That's all that's in the pool, though. The pool looks much cleaner now, thanks. But, as Banjo just said, we still have this temperature problem to sort out. Yeah, and your freaky arm. Be nice, Kazooie. He can't help that he has a deformity. Alright, let's go ahead and split up. Now, just using Kazooie alone, let's... Ooh, I'm sorry, I can't seem to clear my throat. Using Kazooie solo, let's go ahead and use the shock jump pad. And that got us a couple more doubloons. Now if we head this way, not into the house. Turtle's View Cave. Got coins. Now this jam jar silo is for Kazooie only, so we have to bring her here alone. Wing Whack. You've lost the safety that Banjo brings. Defend yourself now with your wings. Whirl them around by pressing B, a useful attack, I think you'll agree. Okay, so she now has her own attack, just like Banjo does when he's alone. Good for her. I don't think we can do anything else solo at the moment. I think the first place we're gonna go is over here. To Blubber's Wave Racer. What does that say? Wave Racer Higher? Okay. Hey there, Blubber! Haven't seen you since the first game! Ahoy there! It be your old shipmate, Captain Blubber. How ye going, me hearties? Bit of a hard day, really. Aye, these adventures are all the same. So many places to go and things to find. How's business, Blubber Guts? Not good, land lubbers. All me wave racers are shipwrecked, and the last one was eaten by a fish yesterday. Well, some of you have the last possession for just one doubloon. Okay, I'll buy your last possession for one doubloon. Here you go. Woohoo! Are ye a good one, Banjo? Have a look inside this here crate. Thanks, shipmates. I'll be off to Jolly's for their quiz night. There'll be 1,000 doubloons up for grabs, and if I win, I'll be having me a fine new flying machine. Woohoo! Well, good for him. We'll check out the box in a minute. More importantly, we need to check out the rafters up here. There's a ginger! So that's the first yellow one we found, and there's two more to find for this three-member family. Legend has it that goldfish hold the secret to fast swimming. Now that's actually true. Now what's in the crate? Running shoes. We actually need these. We needed them to run across this water. Then we get the orange ginger. Okay, cool. So we completed the orange ginger family. We got another Jiggy. Alrighty, so I think the next place we'll go is Jolly Roger's Tavern. Pretty sure that's the name of it, anyway. Yep, Jolly's. Now the first thing we're going to do is hop up on the stool. Now notice how there's a gunpowder barrel in here? Well, let's blow it up! We wrecked Jolly's store a little, but he doesn't seem to care. We'll check him out in a minute. Ginger beer. Today's specials, salty dumplings, toad in the hole, and semen surprise. These all sound absolutely tasty. Hey there, Jolly. I'm Jolly Roger, town mayor and proprietor of this lovely harborside inn. I'd love to oblige, but I'm less than jolly at the moment, as my partner's gone missing. That's a shame. Now how about that drink? Where did you last see her? She was out on a wave racer early yesterday evening. I heard a big gulping noise, and when I got outside, she was gone. Perhaps she was eaten by a vicious sea demon. Oh, I hope not. It's happy hour soon, and I'll be needing some help. Would you like to rent a room? It's half price at 2 doubloons, as this naughty mole has dug a hole in the corner of it. Aye, matey! Okay, big boy, show me the money. Love this game. Lovely, I'll just open the door for you. Cheers, but how can you possibly sleep while my partner is still missing? Quite easily, actually. Oh, I'm sure she'll turn up eventually. It's a cozy room, I guess. Anyway, there's another ability to learn here. Sub-Aqua Egg Aiming. When in the water and baddies attack, this new move will let you shoot back. Press up C for the aiming sight, followed by Z to start a fight. Dismiss. Oh, jam jars. You goofball. So that was worth the 2 doubloons just to get a new ability. Ooh, jukebox. The salty semen shanty. Unfortunately, it is broken, but I think one of the last codes you get from Cheeto is a way to fix the jukebox. And you can use it to listen to the game's music, essentially. Just kind of cool. Anything around here? No, but there'd be a large pirate. There's also pictures of a Treasure Trove Cove around here. Now, I actually remember this guy, because there was like a couple pictures of this pirate in Banjo-Kazooie. I think there was one in Mad Monster Mansion? Yeah, that's the name of it. Avast there, ye scurvy dogs! I be Captain Black Eye, fearless pirate, and scourge of the seas. Looking a tad wobbly there, Blackie. Just a touch of seasickness, you filthy rats. Seasick? Some pirate you are. Watch your tongue, buzzard. Shiver me timbers, these seasick tablets Jolly gave me are mighty useless. I think if we keep bugging him... Splice the main brace. One more press of that thar button, and I'll run ye through. Oh, really? Right, I'll slit your... Oh, me poor stomach. Just take these doubloons and fetch me another glass of water. I wonder if he says anything else. He fell out of his seat. That's kind of funny. A bear stole me glory. Looked a bit like you. He did. Wasn't me. Anyway, yeah, if you bug him enough times, he eventually gives you two doubloons to leave him alone. Next, we'll pay Mumbo a visit. Now, sad to say that Mumbo only has one use for this world. That sounds kind of depressing to say. But for Jolly Roger's Lagoon, there's only one thing he can do. But it's definitely going to help out a lot, so we definitely need to do it. Now, first of all, notice how there's a crack in his wall in this particular skull? Let's see where it leads. Hey, I remember this enemy from Banjo-Kazooie. And that's Tip-Top. Hey there, Tip-Top. Seems to be the problem, Tip-Top. It's my baby. He's about 32 weeks late. Can you help? Can't you just sit on it and hatch it? I'm a reptile, not a bird. He's supposed to get out himself. This is another problem we're not going to be able to solve anytime soon, because Kazooie needs to learn the hatch ability. And she doesn't learn that until the next world. Now, is the Globo in here? I have a feeling it's not. No, it's not. I think I know where it is, though. Oh, wait, I know where it is. Yeah, I remember now. We need to go into the pawn shop. Pawno's Emporium. Now, you'll notice here he has a Jiggy for sale. He also has some other various references, like there's a portrait of Brentilda in the back. There's the Grunty doll that you could... That was one of the prize options from the quiz show in Banjo-Kazooie. And I think that's it. Anyway, let's rob him of his goodies first. Okay, so the Globo's accounted for. Let's talk to Pawno. Greetings, friends. The name's Pawno. I'm the local pawnbroker. Ah, yes, a real nice piece circa Banjo-Kazooie, so I was told. I reckon 20 gold doubloons would be a fair price. 20 doubloons? We only want the Jiggy, not your whole shop. Oh, well, let's just pay the man. Aye, matey. Here's some gold. Pleasure doing business. Please help yourselves. Thank you very much, sir. Now, if we leave and then go right back in, we should have a Cheeto page up for sale as well. Ah, yes, he does. Hello again. How much for the worthless old page? Far from worthless, my friend. I was told that page comes from the legendary Cheeto book. Oh yes, I'm afraid I won't take less than 5 doubloons for it. I don't get quality like that in here every day. Yeah, so I see. Page is still available if you want it. I'm sure it would still be here next year. And it would still be 5 doubloons. I will buy it. Here you go. He's just doing his job, Kazooie. He has to make money somehow. Plus, I would totally buy that grunty thing on the shelf. It's kind of cool. Anyway, let's go see Mumbo now. Don't be a Dumbo, go see Mumbo. Now, we're going to be spending the majority of this world underwater, so you might think that oxygen is going to be a problem, but this is where Mumbo comes into play. Whee! Now, we don't have to take him too far, since there's only one thing he needs to do here. There should be a mumble pad right by the edge of the water. Yep, there it is. Sunlight, oxygenated water. What this will essentially do is it'll give Banjo and Kazooie infinite air in the water in this world. Which is definitely gonna be a boon. That'd be handy magic to have, that's for sure. Mumbo shined big light on water. It now has plenty oxygen. Bear and bird not need to hold breath in there now. So that's all he can do here, but it's still a big help. So that's cool. Okay, back to Banjo and Kazooie. Now, before we go diving into the water, there is one more place I'll show you. And that... Oops! That's the wrong way. Now, we did blow up that section of the wall in Jolly's Tavern, so we'll check it out real quick. That way. There it is. Now, straight away, you're going to notice that there's a Jiggy on that far platform. But this is yet another Jiggy that we can't get just yet, because Kazooie's going to need the glide ability, which we don't get until either Pterodactyl Land or Grunty Industries. I don't remember which. Having trouble breathing underwater? Go see the shaman. But I guess we can check underwater real quick. Now that we don't have to worry about, you know, breathing underwater here. But we can't really do much here. Not yet, anyway. Because we needed an ability called the Talon Torpedo, which we'll learn soon. You also notice that... Ah! Get away from me! There was a goldfish there that had, like, a Cheeto page in it. But We need the same ability for it, called a Talon Torpedo. I'll remember this place for later, though. Alright, let's get out of here. A lot of slowdown in that area.